You're listening to the super stories Superdad's Day Off and Supernan's Day Out by Phil Earle, narrated by Tiernan Douieb and published by Barrington Stoke Limited. First up, Superdad's Day Off. Chapter 1. What is normal? Stanley was a normal boy. He was a normal height, a normal weight, and his head was full of normal dreams, the same things you and I dream of. Stanley lived in a normal house with an older sister who was annoying but normal. Even his dog Bonzo was normal. Bonzo liked bones and walks and cocking his leg in places that made Stanley's mum very cross.
Leave it, Bonzo.
There was nothing about Stanley's life that would make you raise an eyebrow. There was nothing that would make you look twice. Except for Stanley's dad. His dad, you see, was not normal or ordinary. Far from it. Stanley's dad was extraordinary. Stanley's dad was a superhero. Stanley's dad was Dynamo Dan, the greatest crime fighter our world has ever seen. Or any other world, for that matter. Day after day, week after week, year after year, Dynamo Dan would save the day.
Help! Help! A comet's going to crash land on top of New York City!
Leave it to me!
Not today, with Dynamo Dan on hand.
Oh, crikey! Oh, blimey! Bad guys have kidnapped the Queen!
Here I come!
Not to worry, here comes Dynamo Dan.
Oh, poo sticks! Robbers have stolen £1 billion from the world's biggest bank.
They won't get away. Dynamo Dan will sort them out. There wasn't a crisis or emergency too big for Stanley's dad. And there were a lot of emergencies, believe me. So many that they all started to make Dynamo Dan a little...
oof.
Tired. That's right. Even superheroes get tired sometimes. I know it's hard to believe, but it's true. And that's why Dynamo Dan had a day off every week. He didn't want to, but Stanley's mum put her foot down.
I don't care if a hurricane is about to hit Hawaii, she yelled. The bags under your eyes are bigger than suitcases. Every Friday you'll have a rest or I'll hide your Dynamo Dan costume. You can spend some time with Stan.
Stanley was delighted. Of course he was. He loved spending time with his dad. After school, we can go to the park, Stanley told his dad with a grin. Imagine how high you can push me on the swings with your super strength.
High enough to grab the moon,
Dad answered with a yawn.
Plus, there's the roundabout. One shove from you and it'll be like riding a roller coaster.
Deal, said Dad, and then I'll take you for ice cream. How about that?
Brilliant,
Stanley smiled. He was proud of having a superhero for a dad. Who wouldn't be? But sometimes it could be lonely too. Dad worked long hours and Stan wasn't allowed to ring him for a chat. It wasn't possible to answer a call while you were saving the world. Besides, Dad's costume had no pockets to put a phone in. Chapter 2. Friday arrives.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.